shot is known as the lunch shot. I call it the lunch shot because I execute it with the aid of a toothpick. This shot is known as the lunch shot. The reason for calling this the lunch shot is that it is almost impossible to do it without a toothpick. I call the lunch shot.
Frank Taberski, champion of the world of pocket billiards, will amuse you with a few of his fancy shots.
Playing three balls and one shot. A jump shot, forcing the ball out of the triangle into the corner pocket. A three-cushion bank shot, up and down the cue, spotting the ball in the side pocket.
Mr. Taberski will now give a demonstration of Chinese pocket billiards, the way the game is really played in China. He will attempt to pocket all the balls on the table, banking the last ball. Pleasure to introduce to you the champion of the world of pocket billiards, who has held the title of champion on 9 different...
Playing a very difficult combination double kiss shot, trying to pocket the center ball in this corner. Difficult combination double kiss shot, trying to pocket the yellow ball, the center ball, in this corner. Rail shot, pocketing the ball in the side pocket.
Okay.
A three-cushion bank shot, up and down the cues, making the ball in the side pocket.
Banking the last ball.
A three-cushion bank shot, going up and down the cues, making the ball in the side pocket. Speak it over again, too.
Speak. All right, okay. Go ahead.
A three-cushion bank shot, going up and down the cues, making the ball in the side pocket.
All right.
A three-cushion cushioned bank shot, going up and down the cues, making a 10 ball in the side pocket. Bad again.
Oh,
a three cushion bank shot. Going up and down the cues, making the ball in the side pocket.
That kid, you're ignorant.
A three cushion bank shot. Going up and down two cues, making the ball on the side. Three cushion bank shot, going up and down the cues, making a 10 ball in the side pocket.
Bank shot.
Playing a jump shot, forcing the ball out of the triangle into the corner pocket.
You don't mind if I use my own cue, do you?
Not at all,
Jim. 13 ball on the side.
Ten ball on the side.
The eight ball in the corner. Four ball on the side. The eight ball in the corner. Thirteen ball on the side. Thirteen ball on the side. Play the 11 ball in the corner. Ball on the side. Play the 14 in the corner. Ball in the corner. Ball in the corner. Play the 9. Uh-huh. 13 ball in the corner. 9 ball in the corner. Ball in the corner. The side. Ten ball in the corner. The side. Eight ball in the corner. Six ball in the corner. Seven ball on the side. Seven ball on the side. The 8 ball in the corner. 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 The 8 ball in the corner.
And here, gentlemen, a few random shots with the Wizards of the Cue. Here at at Detroit, a sharpshooting cameraman trains his camera lens on the cue wizards in a freewheeling exhibition of trick shots. With Irwin Rudolph, the Chardon, Ohio challenger, manipulating the ivory spheres here in a more scholarly way. Jimmy Karras has a chopstick specialty that you've got to see, mister, and even then it's hard to believe. Jimmy calls this in the groove. He says anyone can do it with a lifetime to practice. Andrew Ponzi unfurls his railroad shot, a billiard trick that looks like it might have been designed for four men and a boy, but Andrew does it like Svengali pulling a rabbit out of a hat. You never saw a football team that clicked with more precision than Willie Mosconi's favorite play. Mosconi's machine gun nip-up is virtually impossible, but here it is, but with sound.
Thank you. And now they know what's going to the shot and they're going to shoot. That's the idea. Shoot now. That's the idea. Well, knock it up. Okay.
Now quit and look at the camera. A little smile there. That's not quite sure. That's the idea. Okay, fine. Thank you. over.
White ball.